Sorry about everyone, because the first time I use webinar, I don't use for 15 years, and sorry again. Today I'm gonna talking about integral abutment pitch design with soil structure interaction. This the pitch is fairly full speed over Sudbury River and MBTA railroad. The pitch is located in Hopkinton and Westboro. This is an aerial view for Foot Street. This existing bridge looking south. The existing bridge has post 9 ton for H20, 16 ton for Thai 3, 26 ton for Thai 3S2. The bridge has 3-foot sidewalk, which is doesn't meet the AAD, and and also have the substandard guardrail, wide rope guardrail on both approaches that you see on the picture. The existing bit have 4 simple span structure with total span length 184 feet and depth approximately 39 feet. This is a cross section from existing plan 1936. The concrete steel low beam have concrete covering, but in 1936 they reconstruction and they remove the concrete covering and repainting. As you see on the light picture, you see the water leaking and make the end girder is a deterioration. For the second one is concrete T beam. And this one take from picture in 2016 has a spur under the concrete T beam with exposed rebar. The existing bit structurally is deficiency, and superstructure and substructure are in poor condition and was left at 4. The bit had a skew about 10.5 degree, and in span 2 from north has vertical clearance 20 feet 1 inch, north cavity wall and concrete piers 1 and 2 support on timber pile, pier 3 and south abutment wall support on space footing. Why integral abutment is considered as the first choice by many DOT? I do the research. I found out it's not only the in USA, but include in the Europe. Also like to build the integral abutment because there are no roadway joint at abutment. The superstructure and substructure move together to accommodate the required translation and rotation with less induced strain, therefore permitting the use smaller and lighter abutment. Integral abutment bridge differ from the traditional rigid frame. Rigid frame bridge resist the effect of temporal change against to the own back wall, on abutment wall. Second, third is less expensive to construct with no footing, no bearing, only a single row of vertical pile used. Easy to maintain. Initial cost saving due to economic and material uses. And life cycle cost saving to reduce maintenance. proposed bit is a three continuous structure with total span length approximately 186 feet. Both end span between integral abutment and pier are 48 feet, 90 feet long between piers. The bits have curb to curb 32 feet with approximately 40 feet out to out. Bits is skewed at the 10 degrees, same as the existing. The foot street bits carry to 11 foot length to foot shoulder, sorry, to 5 foot shoulder and 5 foot 6 inch wide on each side of bridge. Concrete bridge barrier are CP PL2 with protective skin tie 2. This one showed plan and the Sudbury River flow from east to west and we level the south and north abutment. This span length 48, 90 feet and 48 is arrangement to avoid the existing abutment and to remove and allow the proposed substructure to build in between. We can improve vertical under clearance above track 3 more inch. Approximately 9.5 foot long U integral wing wall between integral abutment and end post. This is longitudinal section. Slide bearing is used on piers. As you see in this section, the proposed integral abutment has small size, much smaller size than existing. Only 3.5 thick integral abutment are supported on only single row of pi HP12 by 84. Compact cover bolo is used behind abutment. And we have a 15 feet approach slab with a key at each end in the core abutment. South pier consists of bend cap, 3 foot diameter column, 4 foot dual shaft with 6 feet lock socket. We also have keeper box to use to protect the superstructure, protect the superstructure lateral movement. North pier have 3 columns, 10 foot high cash wall, dual shaft cap and 4 foot diameter column with permanent steel casing. Dual shaft also have 6 foot lock socket. This is a typical integral bed bridge design that used in this project. They have a cast stone construct below integral abutment is placed in loose to allow to reduce resistance to the pi movement. For this project and in the government with design. For superstructure design, the connection between beams and abutment is assumed to be pin connection. For integral abutment design, superstructure is assumed to be fixed to the abutment. For gate 50, there are only two SPI are capable develop a full plastic state distribution. This section are compact section HP by 57 and HP 12 by 84. We use HP 12 by 84. Pi are considered to be full base against lateral torsion buckling and gauss spiral buckling, except when the pi go to extremely soft material such as PEEK. Integral budgment load and load factor for design light load abutment and pi, the largest number of traffic lane shall be used by total width. Dynamic load allow land use no multiple person for shall be applied. For this project, we have two cases. First, three lane load as if the sidewalk is part of travelway. Second, two lane load plus pedestrian load. Uniform temperature load, one is used all the time. This is a bona fide interaction equation is used for compact section only, such as HP 12 and 84, HP 10 by 57. And pi have to be full base again to the torsion buckling. And only apply to the weak axis moment only. For integral wing wall design, extremely event to load combination that have include 1.5 active earth pressure and 10 kip vehicle collision over 5 feet apply on the concrete barrier. For this project, I like to mention the Midas steel composite girder with wizard because this tool is really helpful. It help modeling the initial steel with really quickly. They also is used as a template for another initial bit project. You can modify later. They have four tab. First is layout tab. Layout tab provide span information. Girder type, either composite I-beam, concrete block beam, modeling type, or you can use all frame, all plate, or mix together. They'll provide the deck width, substructure support type, section, you can define deck thickness, conch, diaphragm type, either you use diaphragm as beam or cross beam, cross frame type as X, V and K frame. You can also assign girder section. And you can provide the diaphragm spacing. follow tab. You can assign non-composite and composite dead load. Railing surface. You can assign design moving load, traffic lanes, for this project, you can assign another lane for sidewalk, and after you complete steel composite with wizard, you can define light load as a sidewalk later on. You can select the vehicle either Astro LRD or you can use the PennDOT or California. The last tab is provide deck pour link sequence. Deck length enforcement. In general, I will provide 1% deck length enforcement in deck slab at the negative moment area per ASTO LRD. So this screenshot show how steel composite girder with wizard complete. They show the diaphragm layout exactly what I want. On the bay, on the bay number 6, I'm not quite sure you can see, but it's gonna show the UT support. You can apply, instead you apply UT support on top, you can apply the UT support on the diaphragm later on. BitWizard provide structure group, boundary groups, and load group. This group allow to quickly to select and select many portion of structure, review result in particular portion of structure. It's similar to the AutoCAD or MicroStation that you can turn on and turn off level. This group are also used in the construction state analysis. Integral apartment with soil structure interaction in my dust. The reason why I model integral apartment with in my dust, because the entire structure work together as system provide a more realistic behavior. Soil structure in MIDAS also can generate automatically abutment and pie spin. Avoid using simplified method, equivalent length, to get the point of fixability and no iteration between other software such as Alpine, FB, Peer, Multi-Peer. I mentioned Alpine because the MIDAS already embed formula MATLOG and Lindsay into the MIDAS. Is this a better approach in analyzing bit structure with full soil structure interaction? No hand calculation to determine light load distribution factor and to design bend cap and column. For this project, that required by client, we have two separate models used to analyze and design. First, for girder peer U-shape design, pin connection is used at each abutment and girder end. Model number two is for design integral abutment and HP 12 by 84 pi is fixed at the between girder and abutment. This is a apartment spring used in Midas. The first thing you have to do, you have to change boundary group to the substructure support that create from the bit wizard. Select direction in which elastic link to be assigned. In general, normal positive side is assigned one side and negative side is assigned to the other side of another abutment. And select abutment as you see on the screen, right side, select the plate. Define geometry abutment, soil parameter, thermal expansion. This is soil profile for input pipe spring. We consider the pipe driving to the bedrock is an end bearing, and we consider lock socket to be fixed end condition. We also consider no vertical linear soil spring on your shaft surface. So after you generate pipe spring in Midas, I will go to the boundary condition and delete the vertical linear soil spring. For soil type, root cast stone, alluvial, gassetil are input in Midas at root sand, medium dense sand respectively. This show how to input the apartment pie. As I mentioned before, all the sand soil material is sand. For select apartment, you can select HP12, 84. Or you can assign dual shaft. Pipe diameter for HP12 84, I'm gonna input 12.3 inch. For dual shaft, I'm gonna enter 48 inch. Unit weight, earth pressure coefficient and atlas subgate reaction. All value is shown on the previous page. This showed the whole structure deform based on temperature rise. As you see, it is actually deformation. But if you see and notice it, the horizontal movement is on the top of the abutment. If you model abutment is a stick beam and connect top high with digit link, the deformation of the bridge is not going to be the same as this one. It's not realistic. This is a composite Eye-Girder report that show really detailed. I really impressed Midas that they can provide such a detailed step-by-step computation with the equation include. Also, you provide element that we export and section property. Not only steel composite, Midas can provide steel detail code check for diaphragm and intermediate airframe also provide header, you know, it's a name company that you is ready to submit to the client. This show how moment diagram to the HPI based on strength one load combination with thermo load factor one. As you see, it's a moment at weak acid normally gonna higher than strong acid because we turn the web parallel to the center line of abutment. This one is the steel HPI code check. That's my what? That's my dust perform and list the member and property to be checked. As you see on the left hand side, the ASTO RFD load combination is 0.83, is less than 1. It means HPI still remain elastic. So no modified equation used to be checked. If you select the graphic on bottom corner, you're gonna get the HP section and list the checking or design parameter and load. Again, MyDAS is provide steel code check for steel HPI, similar to the intermediate and end diaphragm. This is a RC concrete column cap U-shape design or code check. I showed this load collision. I show collision impact load on cash wall because it's controlled for U-shape design. Case 2, I show at cohesion load on cash wall between column. Case 3, on cash wall at the center column. And I have so many questions from the engineer in my office and ask me why moment at the bottom shaft is not equal FY time you shape high or not equal to the some moment on the top because non-linear speak in my dust is already distribute the load load as you see on the right hand side shear gonna be reduced because the non-linear spin. Again, and MyDAS is performed in for concrete design code check for the column and U-shape. MyDAS also provide PM interaction diagram in 3D view. And section that you can review. And again, this one is a report. That's my dust provides us to review and check step by step. The last topic I want to talk the wood armor moment in my dust civil and wall design. Wood armor method allow moment to triad from plate moment mx, my, and twisting moment to transform into Bow bending moment in two direction for enforcement design of plate element. This is important if the twisting moment MXS is significant. Not only design for is in the orthogonal system, Binance can calculate reinforcement direction in any skew direction using wood armor moment. This is a formula of a wood armor moment that you can find in Midas Civil Online Manual. Before you can read the wood armor moment, you have to define domain. You have to select the page and define particular domain and define subdomain and rebar direction. On the right hand side, you see it's 90 degree, but actually you can define any direction because in develop inside skew, you can paste the reinforcing in skew direction. And the secondary reinforcement is parallel to the girder. This show active earth pressure movement comparison on integral one main beam ball. The maximum movement MXX 5.2 keep fit. Why is the maximum wood armor is 10.5 and the result show is like it's a 101% increase. This showed how to apply trapezoid pressure on back of the integral abutment. So what you can do, you just input gradient tendency k passive time unit weight of soil and Midas can generate pressure for you. The Binance recognize how high of the wall and they calculate exactly what I calculate. As you see, keep is 5.3 and 5.25. This show how passive moment pressure affect to the integral abutment. And I compare moment MYY and moment wood armor moment that show is wood armor moment is increased 20%.
Hi, Suthichai. I don't hear you at this moment, just in case you are continuing your discussion. Okay, sorry about the trouble. I think it has some minor problem. with his computer and internet. So until he comes back, his slides were almost finished. So let me take a moment to briefly introduce what questions have been submitted, if Suthichai joins us at a later time, we'll cover the questions together.
Hello. Hi. Hello. Yes.
Hi, Suthichai. I can hear you. Are you back online?
Yep. I already online all the way, I think.
Right. Great. So let me switch the screen to my computer, and okay. Let's go over the question together. And some questions, there might be some questions that you have to look into further to answer. So if there are any questions like that, feel free to just mention that you would like to answer, after the session through an email or so. Okay, we have about 15 questions submitted. So here we go. Actually, can you please answer the first three questions, Suthichai? So the first question, if you take a look at my screen, the first question was why, were the steel girders not spliced at the pier?
Based on time out and earlier, we found out the near zero moment is out of the, is not in at the pier. It's beyond the pier.
Okay, great. How could we say piles are prevented for the lateral torsional buckling?
That's a good question. Because this one based on mass dot criteria.
Mm-hmm.
If the pile not go to the really soft material, they consider to be full base. Lateral torsion buckling. Again, the lateral torsion buckling. And question number three.
Yes. Why uniform temperature factor 1.2 is not used? It's according to ASHTO, but was it something specific to mass DOT again?
Yeah, it's mass DOT always use 1.0. I agree. I ask the same question. Why not use 1.2? But because we use the mass DOT, so we have to use the temperature load factor 1.0.
So mass DOT specific. Okay, great.
Yep.
The question four and five, I will briefly answer. How do you define soil properties in MIDAS without the interaction between other softwares? Basically, you're in MIDAS, you don't really have to bring soil spring parameters. You're basically inputting the soil information, like is it loose sand or dense sand or is it clay? You input the soil type and property information, weight, density, and things like that. So you don't really have to iterate it with other, pile software. And that's actually what helped Suthichai to see, he was able to picture, see more realistic behavior of the entire structure together. And number five, why do we need two models in the previous slide? So what this question meant by the two models is that when Suthichai introduced the two interfaces for inputting the soil information, there were two function palettes. For the soil spring generator function, you can do it manually too, but for the automatically generating tool, there are two modes. One mode for generating the pile springs, and the second mode for generating the springs for the abutment wall. So that's why we had two different models. And the next set of questions, So number one, I can answer this one too. Does the calculated spring stiffness behind the abutment wall vary? You know, is it different along the depth of the abutment? Yes. So when you input the information for the abutment wall spring, there's actually an input required that you pinpoint the elevation of the ground and the height of the abutment. So the software actually asks you such input, and those numbers are actually considered for computing the different stiffness along the wall depth. And the second question were, are the springs elastic or nonlinear? For the vertical stiffness of the wall and the pile, linear type of springs are used. For the pile, the lateral soil impact, nonlinear springs properties are defined. And for the abutment wall, compression only spring is defined with the single stiffness. And for number three, Suthichai Uju, can you please answer this question?
Because the concept in mass theory, integral main bit design, is HP pi have to be oriented to the weak axis, allow integral main to move. So to reduce the what I think I mentioned about that is that abutment shall be on the single row of flexible pi with web oriented parallel to the center of abutment. Because the integral abutment is used to accommodate the temperature movement. That's all that I asked for.
Okay. And yes, and the fourth and fifth question too, please.
For in this project, I did not consider skin friction because all the pie gonna dry to the bedrock. But I apply the vertical reaction at the pie tip. So I delete all the vertical linear spring in my dust.
Okay, do we have to consider the passive earth pressure on abutment in LRFD load combinations or not?
Yes. Actually, all in the go abutment, we consider all factor vertical loads passive earth pressure. But in the slide that I showed before, I want to compare moment MYY and wood armor. That's why I did not show the load combination. But actually, yes, we design load combination of RFD design.
Okay. Thank you. And yes, can you please address the questions here?
That is mean, you mean on the report? I'm not quite sure what this means. Yeah, I believe it's yes. Design check automatically used.
Right, yes, the answer is yes. And do the pile springs account for the difference in response moving forwards and moving backwards? The response is stiffer when the abutment moves back.
I would say yes, because on the abutment spring, it's only compression spring is used.
Right.
And number three, I try is I found out the result is come up different. It's if you divide the page element smaller, the slightly the moment is gonna be higher. I try before. Yes, I say yes. And is there any tube to mess? I say yes, this one, but I never tried before.
To answer this part then, if there is an auto meshing tool in Midas, the answer is yes. But if you were to, like, let's say if you're meshing a wall component, you know, something straight, yeah, you can automatically mesh it. If you want to mesh something completely like circle, like sphere-like geometry, there's a module that will actually mesh it for you, like ANSYS or Abacus and things like that. Number four, did you use any plain elastomers at abutments, and why MFP is not applied for live load?
This one is no, we don't have the elastomeric on the abutment, and it's we use the pedestal and paste concrete, cast the paste concrete integral to the abutment and the girder, and because the mass DOT require for integral abutment pi to have maximum light load entire the bridge without consider the sidewall. For example, if you have 3-lane load, when you apply MPF, it's gonna be 0.85, and Matthew C want to conservative when decide the integral abutment and pi.
Okay.
And, yeah.
Oh, sorry.
No, it's all set. Yeah, it's the question. That's the answer.
Okay. That's actually the end of the question. The remaining, there were several remaining questions. But for the sake of time, we'll follow up with you in the email. This presentation will be actually published on Midas webpage, and the link will be actually sent to you together with the PDH certificate. Before you go, I just want to thank Sufi Chai for okay. your presentation. Thank you very much. I learned
a lot. Thank you, Angela. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone, for attending.
And the next one upcoming is on May 23rd at the same time. It's actually going to be spoken by Doug Metcalf. He's an engineer at AECOM. He's actually in Denver, but the project that he's going to be presenting about will be in, it's a project in Louisiana, actually. It's a post-tension concrete U-girder bridge design project. So if you are, you know, if you do similar type of work, or if you are interested in doing how he managed tensions, construction staging, or irregular girder, you know, like girder spare or deck widening, those type of geometric issues. Yep, besides that, we are done for today. Thank you for your time, and thank you for your great presentation, Sufi Chai, and I hope to get to see you all in the next session. Have a very nice day, and we'll end the session here today. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Angela.
Thank you.